Today is April 3rd, 2022, and it's also the second day of Nisan in the year 5782 on the Hebrew calendar. Welcome to the My Love is One podcast. I'm your hostess, LeTicia Lee. If this is your first time visiting, welcome. Today, we're going to be delving into part two of Seeing and Knowing God for Yourself. This is part two of the series. I was initially just seeing God for yourself. I included knowing God for yourself because not everyone will necessarily physically see and recognize the Almighty visiting. However, you will get to know the Creator for yourself. And the best way to do that is to open up the living Word of God and allow the Holy Spirit just to infuse the room and yourself, in your mind, in your heart. And you will eventually develop the relationship for yourself if you're not familiar. I'm also the author of the book, My Love is One, where I shared some of the experiences where I had conversations with the messengers, the divine messengers sent from the Lord who are setting up the messianic era. The book is currently in being edited. It's in its third edition. So if I was you, I would just wait for that third edition. It's a lot more clear. I was a bit nervous in that first couple of writings. So we've had to clean up some things along the way. It'll be much more refined. However, the documentary, the four-part documentary series, My Love is One, Tell Them, is available to those who are listening. You can watch it on YouTube, at least part one, and all four parts are now available on Vimeo. You can check out the link on our page or go to YouTube or myloveisone.com. I'm specifically selecting passages that allow you to get kind of into the meat and where the Lord shows up on the page a little bit more clearly for the readers. You can read any part of the Old Testament and it's there, but it's a little bit more clear in some passages than others. Most of the passages are from various scribes and prophets. But there are certain areas where the Almighty shows up and speaks directly. And I really try to get you as close to those references as possible. Although if you just open the book for yourself, you will eventually see and start to ask questions. And it's a bit more clear if you take the time for yourself than to focus on commentaries, which are other people's perspectives, because the book itself is so multidimensional. As we delve in a little bit more, depending on how far the series goes, I will share a little bit more with you, but it's more important that you allow these revelations to come to you directly. It'll become more clear as you follow along in the series and allow these things to unfold for you. Today, the selection I've chosen is Proverbs 4. You can play this back in your own time and or I highly recommend that you open the book for yourself, whether online or the book directly, and study it after we read it together. But I read it out loud because it literally allows that the fragrance, the spirit to kind of flow. And if you play it back and or read it for yourself, I always recommend you read it for yourself. So this is kind of a beginner start, kind of like a jump start for you. Okay. So today's reading is from Proverbs 4, and it's Proverbs in general is known as the Book of Wisdom. Listen, my sons, to a father's instruction. Pay attention and gain understanding. I give you sound learning. So do not forsake my teaching. For I too was a son to my father, still tender and cherished by my mother. Then he taught me, and he said to me, take hold of my words with all your heart. Keep my commands, and you will live. Get wisdom, get understanding. Do not forget my words or turn away from them. Do not forsake wisdom, and she will protect you. Love her, and she will watch over you. The beginning of wisdom is this: get wisdom. Though it cost all you have, get understanding. Cherish her, and she will exalt you. Embrace her, and she will honor you. She will give you a garland to grace your head, and present you with a glorious crown. Listen, my son, accept what I say, and the years of your life will be many. I instruct you in the way of wisdom and lead you along straight paths. When you walk, your steps will not be hampered. When you run, you will not stumble. Hold on to instruction. Do not let it go. Guard it well, for it is your life. Do not set foot on the path of the wicked, or walk in the way of evildoers. Avoid it. Do not travel on it. Turn from it and go on your way. For they cannot rest until they do evil. They are robbed of sleep until they make someone stumble. They eat the bread of wickedness and drink the wine of violence. The path of the righteous is like the morning sun, shining ever brighter until the full light of day. But the way of the wicked is like deep darkness. They do not know what makes them stumble. My son, pay attention to what I say. Turn your ear to my words. Do not let them out of your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to one's whole body. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Keep your mouth free of perversity. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. Give careful thought to the paths of your feet, and be steadfast in all your ways. Do not turn to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil. That was from the Book of Proverbs, chapter 4. Play this back in your own time. Read it, whatever version of Proverbs 4 works best for you, for yourself. Again, I'm selecting specific scriptures that really help to open your mind and heart to receiving and recognizing the Almighty God for yourself, because the day will come when all will be able to see and hear and learn from the Lord directly from themselves. And we are coming into a new era known as the Messianic era, and there are a lot of changes taking place in the atmosphere and in our world. And it'll be a lot easier for you and your family if you make these connections for yourself to make right decisions that work best for you, your family, and all of humanity. All right. So I hope you enjoyed that. That was from Proverbs 4 today, in the Tanakh and the old. We read from the Old Testament of the Bible, and that is the section of the Bible and the only part that's sanctified. So read the book for yourself when it comes out. My Love is One. Third edition. In the meantime, you can check out My Love is One. Tell them online. It's free to view on Vimeo and on YouTube. All right. Thank you so much. Once again, that is the My Love is One podcast. That was part two of the Seeing and Knowing God for Yourself series. Take care. Stay blessed. And we look forward to our next visit.